I'd like to show you a few little short video clips. At the end of it, I have something extraordinary to show you.
I've always believed in God, and I really don't like it.
Drivers are sounding off about this billboard along the 8 in La Mesa. It reads, "Don't believe in God, you are not alone."
If you don't believe in God, we're letting them know they're not alone, that there's other people in this area like them.
Debbie Allen Skolmer heads up the local Coalition of Reason. It's the group behind the billboard.
Some people may respond negatively to the question, but that's not the point. We're not here to offend anybody.
Skolmer, a non-believer herself, stresses this is all about letting people know there are others out there who don't believe in God.
With so much attention given to religion, they feel very left out, and they also feel discriminated against.
The American Sociological Association research demonstrates that atheists are the most distrusted people in the world, and there's good reason for that. Now, I'm not going to sit here and say that everyone who says they don't believe in God is an atheist. Atheists don't understand atheism. Atheism means without a God. Doesn't mean no belief in God. The truth is, everyone who calls themselves an atheist is an agnostic, because they cannot know there is no God. I think the only people that misunderstand atheists are atheists. Okay, now I want to share with you a few lines of scripture, and then I'm going to show you something truly extraordinary. Luke 21 states, "And as some spake of the temple, how it was adorned with goodly stones and gifts, he said, As for these things which ye behold, the days will come in which there shall not be left one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down. And they asked him, saying, Master, but when shall these things be, and what sign will there be when these things shall come to pass? And he said, Take heed that ye not be deceived, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ. And the time draweth near. Go ye not therefore after them. But when ye shall hear of wars and commotions, be not terrified, for these things must first come to pass. But the end is not by and by. Then said he unto them, Nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and great earthquakes shall be in diverse places, and famines and pestilences, and fearful sights and great signs shall there be from heaven." Now, we're all familiar with the fact that there have been in recent years, in the last 20, 30 or 40 years, a number of people who have claimed to be the Messiah. And they've caused people to commit suicide and do crazy things. There's a fellow, I think, in Mexico right now who claims to be Jesus Christ. He's got a large following. As for pestilences, somewhere near, shortly after the turn of the 20th century, there was a flu epidemic that killed millions. There have been more than one giant epidemic in the 20th century. We know about the AIDS epidemic too, don't we? Millions of people have died. Millions. Can you think in any time in history, in any history book, where it has been recorded that millions died because of a pestilence? That's never happened before in the world, not until around that time, around the 20th century. So we see from the Word of God here that the pestilences that we see occurring in the 20th and 21st century, these are fulfillment of prophecy as well. And famines. What about the great potato famine of Ireland? You see, these kinds of calamities didn't happen on such scale in ancient times. For one thing, the population of the world wasn't great enough. But they just didn't happen either. Rarely was it ever such that a pestilence or famine wiped out an entire culture of people, or even a large population. Great wars. How many we've had? Two world wars in the 20th century. World wars in which millions died. More people died in the First World War than have lived on the earth probably in the preceding several centuries. More people died during World War II then were probably born on the earth in the previous two or three centuries. Okay, so now let's go to the United States Geological Survey's website. They have a list of every earthquake ever recorded in history. 1800s, a couple per year. 1889, 1899, 3 and 4 a year. Just 3 or 4. 1906 and 7, 2, 3, 4 a year. 1908, just a couple. 1915, just a couple. 1916, looks like 4. 1927, looks like about 5. 4 or 5. 1932, 5 or 4 or 5. 1940, 3 or 4. 5 or 6, maybe. 1946, looks like about 5 or 6, 7. 1952, about 5. 1957, a lot, right? Look at there, about 10, 12. 1958, 3 or 4. 1959, just a couple. 1964, a couple. Now look at 1965. 1965, dozens. 1967 and 8, just a few. 1969, just a couple. 1970, a couple. 1972, increase, about 4 or 5. 1973, 4, just a couple. 1975, just a few. 1978, 9, just a few. 1980, just a few. 1985, 5 or 6. 1987 or 8. 1990, just a couple. 1992, just a few. 1997, 8. We're skipping ahead here. 1999, 2 dozen or so. Now look at 2000, a dozen. Now look at 2001, a dozen. And now look at 2002. Would you look at all the earthquakes that occurred in 2002? Dozens and dozens. 2003. Look at this. Dozens and dozens of earthquakes. The list goes on and on. Seems endless, doesn't it? Unbelievable. 2004. The same thing. Dozens and dozens of earthquakes. Many of them catastrophic. 2005, dozens and dozens of earthquakes. Look at this, 2006, dozens. 2007, dozens and dozens. 2008, dozens and dozens. 2009, look at this. Unbelievable. It just goes on and on. Pestilences. Massive disease and pestilence and death in the 20th and 21st century. Wars. Massive wars costing millions of lives in the 20th century. False prophets, especially in the latter quarter of the 20th century. Coming in the name of God, calling themselves the Christ, leading people astray. They're everywhere. Seems like every so many years there's a new one. And earthquakes in diverse places. What we're seeing is prophecy being fulfilled before our eyes. It won't be long and Christ will be here. If you don't know Jesus Christ, get to know Him. There are two possibilities when He comes, just two. One, you accept Jesus Christ as your Savior and follow Him and get to know Jesus in the Spirit, and your sins were forgiven and they'll be wiped away, and God will shower you with love for eternity. There is no greater love than God's love. The other option, I'd rather not talk about it.